What is going on, everybody? It is E-Rock here, bringing you guys a brand new video. Hope you guys are all having a great day today. Today's video, we are going to be talking about the M13. I think I made a video on this a couple weeks ago, but I've made a slight adjustment to the build of this gun. It's an absolute laser beam, even less recoil than before, and it absolutely melts if you give it a chance. If you guys enjoy the video, like, comment, and subscribe. It always helps the channel grow each and every day. And if you are interested in any links down below, we have Twitter, Twitch, if you want to check out my live streams or anything like that. So without further ado, let's get into this build of the M13. The M13 is often overlooked in Call of Duty's Battle Royale, as it can lack some punch over distances and is slightly less effective than the most loadouts when it comes to like the M4 or the Grau. However, the M13 is a machine in close and mid-range battles with next to no vertical recoil and the rate of fire that makes up for the low damage per shot rating. On top of this, it's also very mobile and quick to aim down sights with. And sure, it might knock down quickly over longer distances, but it's quite accurate, and at least that means if you continue to keep hitting your shots, you will get long-range knocks here and there. It's harder to quantify, but the M13 simply just feels good to use in Warzone, provided you don't try and kill snipers with it. Sometimes you can be successful, okay? In order to get the best out of this gun, I've put together a little bit of a different attachment loadout than I did before. For this specific loadout, I've tried to improve the range with less recoil. The aim down sight is slightly more, but believe me, it will be worth it in the long run. And it ensures that it has all the essential features it needs to be one of the better Warzone guns, namely being a suppressor and having a big magazine. So for this current build, I have, again, the Monolithic Suppressor, reduces your sound but improves damage downrange. The Tempest Marksman Barrel. I also have on the Corp Combat Hollow Sight with the blue dot. If you haven't unlocked the blue dot yet, it is quite a grind to get it. It's just more tedious. It's not hard to do, but I've been enjoying using the blue dot on some guns, just always using the VLK, just having a little switch up with the blue dot. It's quite satisfying. The big attachment change on this loadout specifically is on the underbarrel. Instead of using Commando, I threw the Ranger foregrip on just to steady out that recoil even more than it had been before. And I was quite surprised. It is an absolute laser beam. And then finally, you can throw on the 60 round mags. You can also choose to use the other magazines if you choose to help you with that ADS timing and everything. But matching all these together, like I said, it is good for short to medium range. Medium range, it probably does the best. And long range with the better recoil, you actually can knock people from a distance and with quite a shorter amount of time. And if you haven't tried anything out like this before, I highly recommend it. I just wanted to keep this video short, sweet, to the point. Hope you guys did enjoy it. Let me know if you guys like this loadout or if there are any loadouts you want me to try to use. But that is going to be it for me. Thank you guys for the support as always, and I will see you in the next one.